In our current lesson, we want to place that icon inside the place an icon inside the disk and also have it be let's say responsive in terms of the device width. Okay, so what I want to do right now is to start playing some more, just like we've done earlier with the disk, in order to find out how to create a responsive disk, right? I want to play a bit with the position, absolute and relative, and find out about the relation between them so you can understand it. So let's go over here and into our CSS. I will create a new file, test.css. I'm going to write code into this test.css just for us to play with, so it's easier later on to clean up, right? So what I want to do now is to create over here a class selector for a passable element that has a class of test, and I'll do padding 1rem, and then I will do test 1, which will have a background color of C00, which is like a dark red, and then I will do more of them using Alt Shift Down Arrow. Okay, so I got test 1. Well, not necessarily test. This is wrong here. Anyway, let's get back to it. The idea is to create a few of them so we can play with. And this will be 036 dark blue. This will be 0f0, which will be a green. And let's try a pink if I can do it. F00. No, that's not pink. 00f. Well, I don't know how to do pink yet. However, maybe I can use the color picker. Okay, maybe F0F. Yes, I found pink. Cool. So, this is not just test. This is something that has class that starts with test. Okay. So now, I'll save this. And if we are to go into our index.html all the way to the top, just before the grid, I can do the div with the class test 1 that has inside it a div with the class of test 2 that has inside it a div with a class of test 3 that has inside it a div with a class of test 4. So let's save it, and if we are to switch to our browser, well, we shouldn't see anything, but we can definitely see that there are those divs inside, right? So why is that? It's because we've added some CSS to the test file, but the test file is not loaded. So in here, we are not pointing to any test file, and in the style CSS, we are not importing it. So let's do just that. Import test.css with a semicolon at the end, otherwise CSS complains, and now we should see the divs inside, right? Now, I want to start playing with the let's say the div that is the innermost. So I'm talking about this one over here, the pink one, right? And I will add to the pink one the property position with the value of absolute. So what do you think it will happen once I do that? So let's do position absolute. Okay, well, not was what I was expecting. Anyway, let's do also top 0. Okay, so it looks like it's positioned to the very top. And then if we do left 0, well, then it's positioned to the very top of the browser and also to the very left of the browser. So it doesn't have any relation to the previous, let's say, elements. Okay, so what happens over here? Let me quickly explain. So the way CSS works is that it's going to... This one has a position of absolute, right? So what position absolute does, it's going to go up one parent, and then if it doesn't find something, it's going to go another parent until it ends the body, right? And it's going to ask each of those parents, do we have a position with the value of absolute, relative, that's R, or fixed, okay? So it's gonna ask, do you have a position with the value absolute, relative, or fixed? Okay, so This div over here does not have it. So then it goes to the parent of that one. Then the parent of that one doesn't have it either, which means it goes to the parent of that one, which it asks again, do we have a position relative absolute or fixed? When div test one doesn't have, again, one of those values, then it goes up to the body, and then that's where it ends. So now our div will have a top of zero from the, let's say, border top or the top edge of our body, and it will have a left zero from the, let's say, left edge of the body. All right, let's clear a bit up and make sure that we are on the same page. Because if we do a top of, let's say, 2 pixels, it's going to be, or 5 pixels, it's going to be 5 pixels away from the top edge of the body, right? And if we do a left of 5 pixels, it's going to be 5 pixels away from the left, right? Now, if we want to control this, let's say this element with the class test for somehow in relation, right, to one of the other parents, we decide which parent, but how do we do that? How do we decide? Well, for example, if we go for this test one and we add position relative, suddenly the test 4 went and asked test 3. Test 3 didn't have any of the position relative fixed or absolute. Then it asked test 2, which didn't have any of the position relative fixed or absolute. Then it went and asked test 1, do you have a position with either relative, fixed or absolute? And then test 1 said, well, I have a position relative. So then test 4 stopped looking any further because it found the very first element that has those values, and then it stopped over there. Now, what that means is that test 4 is going to have its top, left, bottom, and right in relation to test 1, because test 1 has position relative and test 4 has position absolute. So that's how you can control where an element with position absolute will stop looking for, let's say, other elements that are parents or are ascendants of him and have either position relative, absolute, or fixed. So with that said, let's get back to our, let's say, test, to auto, not test, to our code. I'll remove those ones or at least comment them out. Maybe we use them later. And let's get back to our disk links. And inside our disk link, I want to grab the very first one that is Udemy, right? So this one, I want to grab it and place it inside. So let's see in the CSS, there's a tile font. It should be a font, control P. And we go to the font that sits inside the web CSS. And then we can see here, there's code words. Somewhere it should be Udemy. Okay, we got Udemy. So my CV, Udemy. Okay, let's grab that code, go into control P, index.html, and then let's paste it in here and hit control space, and then it will launch the autocomplete of the suggestions, and we can use that to generate a div with the class MyCVUdemy. Okay, so now if we scroll all the way down, we can see that there is a div with the class MyCVUdemy. See, it's this one over here. However, I wanted it to sit inside some other ones, like, well, this one, like, so I didn't put it in the right place. Okay, I wanted to put it inside here. So I pressed enter, then I'm gonna use Ctrl Shift K to remove that empty line. And then this one, I will use Alt and up arrow. Okay, so now it should sit inside the very first one. Okay, it does sit inside the very first one. Now it kind of deformed a bit that shape, but let's fix it. So firstly, for this disk link on AHAO, I want to go to the style CSS, which is over here, and then find that disk link, this one. Let's add a position relative to it, right? And then inside it, what do we have inside it? We have this MyCV Udemy, right? So let's select, I will select from line 33 to 40 because I want also this space at the top, this one. The line 33, I want it. So I will select like that and press Alt Shift Down Arrow. This is not necessarily something you want to do is just me being efficient in how quickly I write code. So my intention is to continue this selector, but write a different one. So continue this selector with something else, right? So I don't want this code over here. So it's easy for me to duplicate it like that and don't have to copy paste. Again, copy paste is not necessarily the best option for you. And I want to select this link that has inside it a tag with the attribute class that starts with the value of my CV. And this one, I want it to have a position absolute, pos A. Okay, so far, let's see what we've got. Or something happened. What if we remove the position absolute? It's still there, right? So if the position absolute is no longer there, but this one is there. My CV demi, this link on a how. Okay, what if we do for this one a top of 0? Yeah, that fixed it. And a width, not width 100%, height 100%, and left 0. So basically we told it start from the very top, start from the very left, and then span as wide as you can and as tall as you can. So let's just add those ones to our code as well, because if we refresh the page, it goes away. Again, whatever changes you make in the inspector will be gone at the next refresh. So let's save this code. So far, we've got something working. However, I want to position that icon to the center, and let's do a display flex and then justify content center and align item center. So that's what we've got. We got the icon inside there. Let's copy this and paste it in here. And now let's see what else needs to be done over here. I will disable the, let's say, mobile emulator. And as far as you can see, that icon is pretty small over there and it's good right now. It's close to what we want right now, but when it gets bigger, it's pretty small. So we don't have to worry too much about the entire, let's say, spectrum of range, let's say, width ranges. However, let's say, if we start from 320, that should be the lowest mobile gets, as far as I know. It might go even lower, but that might be watches or something else. So let's say, in general, mobile span from 320 as width to maybe 700 something as width. Other than that, it's no longer mobile territory, it's tablet territory, more or less. So again, so we can definitely play with a value over here, but we are talking about this this font over here. So a unit that we can use that has again a relation to the width is the viewport width. So let's do font size 1 viewport width. Again, I'm talking about this one over here, right? So font size 1 viewport width. Okay, so we got font size 1 viewport width, but that's quite small over there. So let's increment it to, well, 8 looks fine. 9 looks fine as well. Not sure now which one. 8, 9, 10. Let's do 9. And now let's play a bit with the width. And as far as you can see, it's not definitely perfect. I think for 320. For 320, it's a bit too big, so let's do 8 pixels here. 8 not pixels, viewport widths. So let's see, how does it look for 700? Looks okay. Definitely better than the smaller one. So let's also add this font size to the before selector. Okay, so again, if I want to continue adding, or at least adding to this selector in a different one, I want to continue this selector over here for a different rule, set of rules, right? So I'll select that space, Alt Shift down arrow to duplicate it, remove the entire content. And then over here, I'm going to do colon B4. And I will paste that font size 8 viewport width. So right now it looks better. looks better. And if we are to resize it for different mobile versions or different mobile devices, we can see that it's acceptable, definitely. Maybe we find a different solution in the future, or maybe we get better specifications. But so far, this is something I'm happy with. So in our current lesson, we've managed to get the icon to have, let's say, to be displayed in a responsive way in relation to the width of the device. In the next lesson, we'll have the chance to play a bit with the icons and place them inside different color discs. So let's have some fun.